Hi, I am Dr. Selvaraj, Professor of Surgery, Malacca Manipal Medical College, Malaysia. Welcome back to my series of surgical teaching video casts. These are meant mainly for undergraduate medical students doing the surgical clerkship rotation. I promise you will become competent in clinical problem solving and surgical decision making if you are going to watch these videos over and over again. So this is one more image based question video on one of the upper GI tract pathology. So here I am going to show you one more image and you have to answer this. I request my viewers, yeah, this is the this is the picture and these are the questions. I request my viewers to pause the video and then try to answer all these questions. So this is an equipment. This can be found in the surgical ward. Question number one, what is this? Question number two, what is it used for? Question number three, how is it deployed? Question number four, name the potential complication associated with the larger balloon. Question number five, what precautionary measure can one take to avoid this complication? So pause this video and try to answer all these five questions, and then in the subsequent slides you can verify your answer with the correct answers. The question number one is, what is this equipment? So the answer is, this is a Sengstaken Blakmore tube. Question number two, what is it used for? So it is an either a orogastric or nasogastric tube. That means you can introduce it either through orally or through the nose. So this is used in the management of upper GI hemorrhage due to bleeding from esophageal varices. Question number three, how is it deployed? So the gastric balloon is inflated in the stomach with 150 ml of dilute contrast for radiological confirmation of the position. So this is the gastric balloon and this is the esophageal balloon. So you have to inflate the gastric balloon with 150 ml of dilute contrast. Then this inflated balloon is gently pulled up against the GE junction. The esophageal balloon is then inflated. The markings on the tubing indicates the distance from the distal end of the esophageal balloon. This is the distal end. So the marking is starts only from the distal end of the esophageal tube. This Sengstaken Blakmore tube has got four lumen, one lumen to inflate the gastric balloon, one lumen to inflate the esophageal balloon, one lumen to aspirate the gastric content, and another lumen to aspirate the esophageal content. Question number four, name the potential complication associated with the larger balloon or the esophageal balloon. Prolonged deployment of the balloon will lead pressure necrosis or rupture of the esophagus. So question number five, what precautionary measure can one take to avoid this complication? So you can release this esophageal balloon at intervals. You should not, put it continuously. This itself is only a temporary measure. If you want to arrest the bleeding, you can, especially if you are working in a Mofusil or peripheral hospital where all the facilities are not available, you can use this Sengstaken Blakmore tube to temporarily arrest the bleeding. So you should not, inflate the balloon continuously. If you are going to keep it for more than 24 hours, definitely there will be pressure necrosis. So in between, at intervals, you have to deflate this esophageal balloon and then you have to reinflate. So thank you very much for watching this video. If you think that these videos are very useful, kindly subscribe to this channel and share these videos in your social media. Thank you once again for watching this video. Let us meet in yet another video. Until then, bye-bye.